Welcome back to Southwest Yard and Garden. I'm John White. Today we're going to be talking about drip irrigation, and drip irrigation is a technique that a lot of people are using nowadays, and there are good and bad things about drip irrigation, and so we want to talk a little bit about how to use your drip irrigation system more efficiently. And with me today is Todd Arnold, and Todd is a manager of the Ewing Irrigation Store here in Las Cruces, and Ewing is an irrigation supply house. And Todd, welcome to Southwest Yard and Garden.
Thank you, John.
What is drip irrigation?
John, drip irrigation is the slow application of water to a specific plant's root zone.
And why are people even thinking about using drip?
Well, for one, John, to conserve water. It gives the plant the water at the root zone where it needs it. It doesn't wet the entire area around the plant if you have your plant sparsely planted.
Okay. Let's talk about some of the components that you need for an irrigation system, and we're going to kind of start out as if maybe some of our viewers are just getting started with the system and maybe aren't familiar with all the parts, or maybe they forgot to put one of the components in. So
okay. Let's
talk about what's needed.
Okay, one of the first things you're going to need is a zone valve. The manual valve that you'll put in front of your electric valve or manual valve, you can just run the manual valve if you want. And do without the, if you don't want it automated,
okay.
You just have it manually
on. Now the manual
off.
Gate valve here helps. If you have to work on the system, you
right.
can shut it off and
any maintenance
and turn
that you
it
would
back
need
on.
To do, you can just turn it off and do your maintenance and then turn it back on.
Okay.
Then you move on to, if you want the automated, to hook into a sprinkler timer. If you already have a sprinkler system at your house and you want to automate your drip system, you can.
Okay.
The two probably most important parts of your drip system is your Y strainer or filter to help filter out any of the impurities that may go through the water system. Water just flows through and gets filtered right through the screen.
Okay, that's real important because drip systems use emitters that put out very small amounts of water, and just a little grain of sand a lot of times can clog those up. So.
It sure will. Also, the regulator is very important. The drip emitters work best around 20 to 50 PSI would be the maximum.
What kind of pressure are we getting off of a house?
A lot of houses in this area are getting 70 to 85 pounds of pressure at the house.
So that'd blow a line out or blow the emitters off the line.
Sure will. If you're in doubt on whether or not you do need a regulator, you can check your pressure at your hose bib at your house just by using one of these pressure testers. You can just screw it right onto the hose bib and it'll give you a reading of what your pressure is at your house.
Okay. Todd, let's talk about emitters.
Okay. The emitter is, most emitters are pressure compensating. They go either in the poly pipe, or you can put them on the end of a spaghetti tube like this one and stake it at the root zone of the plant.
Okay.
A lot of people will feed the stock of the plant the water, but actually you really need to feed the root zone of the plant, not just the stock.
We've got a kind of example of some different emitters here, and I see one that has a whole lot of prongs on it there.
Right, that would be for like a tree or a shrub. They have one hole ready to go, so you can start as soon as you install the emitter. You can put one tube, or if you need them right away, just clip off the ends and you can put all six outlets.
Okay, and we'll attach the spaghetti tube to that and then lead it out to wherever we need it.
That's right, to the root zone.
Okay. What's this tall one with the little green end on it here?
Well, that is actually it's a spray head for a small area.
Okay, this, so if you had a lot of little ground covers and
had a lot of ground covers,
couldn't afford to put all the emitters in.
Right, you would want to put these in so they would spray the entire area, but you would also want those on a separate valve. They would still require the same setup with the Y filter and regulator, but they would not. You would not want to mix them because these are measured in gallons per minute, not gallons per hour. So they would need their own valve.
Okay. Now, with drip irrigation, we're working with poly pipe, maybe in some instances PVC, but usually the poly pipe.
Right.
And there's some tricks to working with poly pipe, right? How do we put an emitter in a poly line?
Well, one of the easiest ways is just with a hole punch. You can punch the hole in.
ice pick.
Polypipe. Ice pick will work. You just want to make sure that you don't go through both sides of your polypipe, but you punch your hole in, and the polypipe will expand back over the hole. So you want to work kind of quick, and then once you're got it, you just push it right in.
We want people to know that emitters do not last forever, that they do clog, they, you know, mineralize, you get mineral deposits on them, and so at times you do have to get rid of an emitter, add emitters. So if we have an emitter that we no longer need, what do we do?
Well, you can just simply pull the emitter out and replace it. It will come right out. If you decide you need to move the emitter, there's also a goof plug, known as a goof plug, that you can just plug the hole off and move your emitter.
Okay, and that allows you to put emitter somewhere else without losing pressure.
That's right.
Okay. Now, we also have some other attachments here as far as working with polypipe.
Right. Sometimes you'll need to tee off to go to a different direction, into a different direction, or you may need to, you have a break or something, and you may need to repair it. This is an insert fitting, a barb fitting. It does require clamps, but it just slides right into the hose, polypipe, and then you clamp it off.
Okay. And then this one?
This is a compression adapter T. You just push the polypipe in, and the polypipe expands around the little ring that's in the T, and it's impossible to get out.
And then at the end of the poly line, when we're at the very end.
Right.
I've seen some people just bend it and kind of put a piece of tape on it.
You can do that. There are several different types of plugs or ends. This is just a plug that works just like the insert coupling that we just had. It pushes in, you put a clamp on. There are also flush end caps. This particular one you would put onto the poly and you would unscrew it to flush it. Anytime you had a break, you'd want to flush any of the dirt out.
That's a good idea.
And then there are also self-flushing ends. Each time that the system comes on, this end will actually flush out about a half gallon of water to flush the line out, any dirt or debris that had gotten into the line.
Okay. Todd, we're kind of getting down to the end of our time here, and we still have a lot of things to talk about, so we will definitely be back next week to talk some more about drip irrigation. But what are some of the things we're going to talk about? What is this brown stuff here?
That's a subsurface pressure compensating drip tube. It has the emitters built right into the tube. Also, multi-outlet emitters we can talk about.
Okay. Todd, thank you for being on Southwest Yard and Garden, and we'll be back next week.
Thank you, John.